What's wrong with the passport?
Nothing. The pooch ain't picking up, so we're stuck here.
Hey, release the dumb scuts. Let us keep our weapons.
They demonstrate their lack of fear. It was a proven battle tactic. Katathian warriors often ride into battle completely naked.
Keep your pants on.
Although, it could be used as a distraction.
Yeah, no.
Any other ideas?
Can you froth?
I can froth.
Can you twitch?
Yeah, I'm pretty twitchy.
All right. On my cue, you drop, froth, and twitch. While they're all distracted, we take off down one of them side halls.
What about me?
You, well, you know, you, take one for the team.
I'm not gonna...
Walk with me!
Come on, Quill, just grab your chest and drop.
Find another plan.
So, the Matriarch asked for us by name?
You, specifically. Although I cannot fathom why.
Peter's constantly surprising us, too. But if he's first in line for brainwashing, I gotta say...
Is that what you think? That we're brainwashing people?
We've met your recent converts. Overly zealous doesn't even begin to describe...
They have embraced the Matriarch's promise. A life-altering experience, yes. But one that must be freely accepted.
Quill, his drone. It's our ticket out of here.
What? How?
What are you two whispering about? Well?
He wants to know if you know you're the bad guy.
We weren't whispering about anything. You were. Talking. We were just trying to...
Plan your escape.
Maybe. Kinda. Can you blame us?
You plan because you fear. And you fear because you have suffered. Once the Matriarch unites us in belief, all suffering, all grief will end. Because those we have lost will return.
This promise will raise the dead?
Of course it won't. We can't bring people back.
We can't. But the Matriarch, the divine vessel...
I got an idea, but I need time. Stall him!
I intended to kill you.
Wow. Okay. That is a cool trick. We'll explain how you did it.
Sorcery.
I can understand how some might see it that way. But I used science. The science of faith.
Faith is not science.
But faith energy is. This skiff. My inquisitors. Even Sacrosanct herself. All powered by the same miraculous energy. Energy I discovered.
I'm going for the drone. Keep him talking.
What now?
What? What is it?
It's just, discovered stuff, and you claim to, control energy?
Faith energy?
Right. Well, it just seems like all this, faith energy is, really, really powerful, and,
I think what Gamora's point is, you say you have all of this energy.
Faith energy.
Right, but when we first saw you, weren't you stranded on Hallis Hope because your shuttle ran out of juice?
Yes, I was, but...
So why didn't you just believe that your ship had more gas?
It doesn't work that way. Faith energy is a byproduct of belief. Focused belief.
Okay, sure.
I saw this proven. Focused belief in him is what enabled us to survive.
So, you were saying...
Wait. Weren't
there more of you?
What? No.
It seems like the kind of thing that we would be aware of.
Indeed.
Please continue your fascinating account of, you know.
But you were saying something about him? It seems super important.
Right. Your father. Uncle. Son?
My son died of disease. The him I was referring to was someone else. The first divine vessel of this church, before it was even a church. An absurd faith healer. Bathed in golden light and wielding unfathomable power. He saw my loss. Our collective loss, knew its cause, but refused to reverse it. Because he, personally, never felt what we feel. That is why I founded this church. To heal. To give hope to those who have lost everything. Wait. There were more of you. Little one is missing.
Perhaps he died like your son.
Margaret!
What?
I am...
What did he say?
Right? Yes. Good point, Groot. He is totally into his spiritual mission. But I think I figured out all of this.
Those were some pretty sweet holidays. I think even the world might look jealous. I mean, they must have cost you an arm and a... well, another arm. Right? And this? That's a pretty sweet trick, too. But everybody's got anti-grav these days. Oh, and let me guess. You got your own personal shield generator tucked under that terror toga, don't you? A little makeup, some color coordination. Oh, loving the gold laser light show, by the way. Sweet little scam. I'm actually impressed.
Well, good for you.
Hey, I get it, man. You gotta sell the brand before you stage the miracle. Oh, man, this one time on Rigel 3...
You think you're all very clever. You hope to delay me because you're afraid. But there is nothing to fear.
Why?
Get back here where I can see you.
Yeah.
It's time to meet the Matriarch.
Rocket, tell me you have an escape plan. We're gonna summon the Milano. My new buddy will show us the way.
We're being very cryptic, Rodent.
Yeah, well, I get twitchy when I'm surrounded by giant murder bots.
They just want us to meet their new mommy.
Speaking of which, who else thinks Quill's ex-girlfriend traded in her cop badge for cult robes?
Come on.
What? I'm just saying what we're all thinking.
The Guardians of the Galaxy.
Thank you, Grand Unifier. Guardians, you may approach.
Peter Quill, order your offspring to come down from there this instant.
Maybe I'm out of line, but aren't you a little young for a dress that short?
Aren't you a little old to write your name on your clothes? Took you long enough.
Yeah, well, you know, chatty grandpa gets.
Hey, we're gonna get you out of here. Just follow my lead.
But this is where we're supposed to be. We're gonna save everybody. I'm gonna save them, I promised.
Come on, snap out of it, kid. You're just saying what he wants you to say.
Of course I am! But I'm more than just me.
What do you mean? Where's your mom?
Mom is here. She's right here. Inside me.
Oh, thanks for clearing that up.
The light joined us. I thought she was gone, but I can bring her back. They're all waiting for us to bring them back. All we need is faith. The Grand Unifier helped me understand.
This is one big con. Trust me, I know a thing or two about...
Why can't you just believe in me? Why won't you just listen? Nobody ever listens. Until I show them. Peter, you can save her. I promise.
Get back! Your scaly mitts won't touch one hair on his head! I said get back!
You should tell your jerks you're gonna pay!
Peter, are you back? I always knew you'd come back! Peter! I imagined this moment so many times!
So did I, Mom! So did I! Real tough guy picking on a lady and a kid. I'll show you.
They aren't going to keep us apart anymore. I'm so happy to see you, Peter. You have no idea what I've gone through.
I have no idea how this is happening right now.
Oh, Peter. Oh, Peter, my boy!
Mom! What's going on? How is this possible?
You saved me! That's how! I knew you would never leave me!
I didn't.
Look at you! Look at you, all grown up! And into the great leader I knew you would become!
Peter, I am so proud of you. Your father would be so proud.
I don't understand. I saw you die. Did I go back?
You are here. That's all that matters. We have all the time in the world now. You and me. And your friends, too.
My friends?
Sure. The house is plenty big enough. And I want to meet this amazing team of yours and hear all about your incredible adventures.
That is... You don't know how bad I've wanted this.
Oh, nothing will ever break us apart. I promise, Peter. I promise.
I can't believe I have you back.
Mom, you're squeezing kind of tight.
We have so much time to make up for. Maybe we'll finally get to finish that game.
Can you feel it? The promise is all around us. The matriarch will reunite us now and forever.
guess that needs replacing. Plugs are like new, so that's not the problem. That was a little loose. Shouldn't be the cause of the problem, though. Might need to top off the oil.
Peter! Dinner's almost ready!
Yeah, be right there, Mom!
Meredith Quill, where do you keep your carving knives?
Oh, there's one in the drawer, nearest the stove.
All I see is a dull instrument fit for a child.
That's the one. There you are, Peter. I was just about to come out and call you again. Some things never change, I suppose.
Ah, Peter Quill. Your mother was just telling us about your childhood.
Just some of your better adventures?
She also told us she had found a suitable mate for you, but you refused to see reason.
Drax, you said that would stay between us.
That's your first mistake, Mrs. Quill.
Oh, yeah. He's the biggest gossip of us all.
Are you still pushing that Janie thing?
She's a lovely girl, Peter, who's turned into an even lovelier young woman.
She does sound pretty nice, Peter.
Better than all the rest of them, for sure, Quill.
All the rest of them?
Your son is rather promiscuous, Meredith Quill.
Dude! Not cool!
Sounds like we need to have a serious talk over dinner, Peter.
Why do I feel like I'm about to get grounded?
You see, the crispiness of the skin belies the juicy flesh beneath.
Oh, why? I mean, I've had chicken all my life, but you make it sound so appealing.
Hey, Quill. Can you do something about your mutt? He won't stop staring at me.
No, he just wants to play.
Maybe you should take him outside, let him chase you around.
Har har! You're just about as funny as this game is exciting.
You know, we could all go see a game next time. It's not much of a game, but it might be a bit more. I'd like that.
That would be an acceptable activity.
Yeah, sounds fun, Mr.